Hello, are you a German who's visiting New York City?
Do you need a coat for walking around the city?
If you have answered yes to either of these questions, you would be a fool not to stop by Bierhoff Brothers, House of German Coats. Hello, I'm Klaus Bierhoff.
And I am his brother, Oliver Bierhoff. For 20 years, we have been providing coats to German families who are visiting the New York City area.
Only a Bierhoff coat says, I'm a German, I'm on vacation, I'm sensible, and I'm wearing a coat that is functional.
Yeah.
I'm with my family, and you can tell because we are all wearing the same coat.
Yes, this is the promise that we make to you with our coats.
Many coats are designed for fashion and so. At Bierhoff Brothers, we believe that those coats belong in the garbage.
Get rid of those coats.
Garbage.
Our coats are no nonsense, and that is the only thing that makes sense to us.
Yes, that is a slogan. It is not a catchy slogan,
no,
but it's a functional slogan.
We believe that catchy slogans belong in the garbage.
Oliver and I are each wearing the new Times Square coat. It's a perfect coat for the Times Square area of New York City.
Yeah, let's look at the features.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, so look, there's an outer reflective band that says to the taxi, do not hit me, Mr. Taxi. And then an inner reflective band that says, hello, taxi, I'm trying to hail you and so. And then there's a hood for when it is raining. And then a second hood for when it is raining harder.
Yeah. And then there is a red flag to extend if you lose your family in a crowd. Family, where are you? Where are you? I need you.
Yes, and so, and also, there's a yelling cone to use if your family does not see the red flag. Hello, family, where are you?
We are here. We are here.
Oh,
we are here.
We are here. I have found you.
The new Times Square coat also takes into account that you're in a cosmopolitan city.
Yes, you have to fit into a fancy restaurant and so. Look, the sleeves are removable.
Oh my goodness.
Look, look, I am now properly dressed for a fancy restaurant.
What is this? Still unsatisfied? Well, my goodness. To that I say, you are being unreasonable. You should be satisfied, Mr. Scott.
Yes, but in an effort to get your business, we've added more features and so.
Yes, we have added a pouch for hard salami.
Yes, a pouch for regular salami.
Yeah, many other pouches. For sausage, a pouch?
For purchased souvenirs.
Look, Klaus, I did not know you had purchased this souvenir.
That's because I was keeping it in my pouch for purchased souvenirs.
Oh.
Finally, the Bierhoff coat is the only coat in the market that can be turned into a tent. Look.
This tent is in case you are robbed and forced to sleep outside until the embassy opens.
Okay, we've explained enough for now. Goodbye.
Goodbye, get away from us.
The Oliver Bierhoff Times Square coat is a proper coat.
Yes, so if you order now, you receive a Bierhoff Brothers fanny pack.
And another fanny pack to keep your fanny pack in.
Hi, I'm Chris Matthews of NBC's Hardball. I hope you're enjoying Saturday Night Live's presidential bash. It's great. With me is Democratic presidential candidate, Senator Barack Obama.
Hello, Chris.
Thanks for spending a few moments with us. You, sir, are great.
Thank you.
But I got a few questions I need to ask you, questions you've so far managed to avoid.
All right.
Okay, about 6 weeks ago, I went online. I ordered the Barack Obama signed poster and the Obama t-shirt, size large, extra large.
And you haven't gotten them?
No, I haven't.
Wow, that's weird. That shouldn't be. Do you have the tracking number on that?
Yeah. XOG. 12L. G332.
I'll get somebody on this. You should have it tomorrow.
Thanks. You're great. By the way, I won't wear it when I anchor election coverage. Don't worry.
Of course.
If I wear it, it'll be under my shirt and jacket.
Uh-huh.
But I probably won't even wear it.
Not a problem.
Sometimes when I watch you give your stump speech, I pleasure myself.
Really?
You're great.
Thank you.
We now return to the presidential bash.
The This is CNN.
Good evening and welcome. University in Nashville, Tennessee, for the second in a series of three presidential debates between Senator Barack Obama of Illinois and Senator John McCain of Arizona. I'm Tom Brokaw of NBC News, and I will be your moderator this evening. Tonight's debate will follow a town hall format with questions submitted by the 80 undecided voters in our audience, as well as thousands more sent in via email. From this enormous list of penetrating, insightful, and provocative questions, I have chosen the 8 least interesting. For each question, the candidates will be allowed a 25-second response and, at my discretion, a 3-second follow-up. These are the rules both campaigns agreed upon. And our first question is for Senator Obama, and it comes from Elizabeth Wheeler.
Senator Obama, over the last few weeks, the financial crisis, which began with home foreclosures, has threatened to wreck the entire economy. As president, how would you deal with this?
First of all, Elizabeth, thank you for that question. There is no doubt that after 8 years of failed Republican policies, policies which Senator McCain supported, this economy is in a shambles. But let me tell you and the American people, one thing I absolutely promise.
Time's up. Senator McCain.
Elizabeth, to find any solution to this economic mess, we're going to have to put aside partisanship, something my opponent, this character here, is not very good at. But I've done my whole career. You know, my friends, I'm not the most popular guy in my own party, just as Senator Trent Lott. I took his car one time without asking and totaled it. Just drove it into a wall and walked away. So I'm not going to win any popularity contests among Republicans. But Maria, when it comes to the economy, here's what I would do. It's very simple.
Time. For our next question, we'll turn to foreign policy. The question is for Senator McCain, and it comes from Kevin Quigley.
Senator, in recent months, Russia has refused to support sanctions on Iran, threatened to cut off natural gas supplies to Europe, and invaded the Republic of Georgia. As president, how would you deal with this new Cold War threat?
Well, first of all, Luther, thank you for your question. And let me start by saying that no foreign policy can succeed if it's not bipartisan. So I would first reach out for the support of Senate Democrats, and if that bothers my fellow Republicans, frankly, I don't care. Ask Lindsey Graham. I once flushed 3 cherry bombs down the toilet of a Senate office. Absolutely destroyed the plumbing. I'm willing to buck members of my own party. Now, Eduardo, as to dealing with Russia, I would order all our nuclear and B-52s into the airspace over that country, and I would deliver the following message to Mr. Putin and Mr. Medvedev. My friends...
Senator McCain, your time is up. Senator Obama.
Kevin, by way of answering your very profound question, let me tell you about an experience I once had. And this is a story I've never told anyone. Now, when I was a young boy, maybe 8 or 9, I was taken aboard an alien spacecraft and held there for about 2 Earth weeks. And I'll never forget something the leader of that alien crew told me.
That's it, Senator Obama. Your time is up.
If I could, this is a really interesting story.
Okay, these were rules both campaigns agreed on.
But
our next question is for Senator McCain, and it comes from Anthony Cipelli.
Senator McCain, over the last 10 years or so, it seems that Americans have grown increasingly divided from one another. How would you bring this nation together?
You know, Oscar, that's a very good question. Here's my answer. I would continue what I've done for 25 years, which is to reach across party lines, something that pee pants over here would never even consider. Because you see, Zebediah, I don't mind upsetting members of my own party. Elizabeth Dole will tell you that. I once got a hold of one of her checkbooks and kited checks all over Washington. Ruined her credit rating. So she'd be the first to agree. I'm no slave to Republican orthodoxy. How was my time?
Just made it.
Yes.
Senator Obama.
Anthony, you've hit the real question. Look, how do we as a people come together? So, let me tell you another story I've never shared before. One I left out of my second book. It's about a man I met many years ago in Chicago. And at first I thought we had almost nothing in common. But over the course of working together, year in, year out, talking to each other, most important, listening to each other, we became friends. Sharing not only that friendship, but our plans for this country's future. And that man, my best friend and my mentor, is former Weather Underground leader and unrepentant terrorist, William Ayers. Now, I'm telling you this because I'm so far ahead in the polls right now, it's not gonna matter.
Thank you, Senator. 1.6 seconds over. We now have a question for both candidates, and it's from William Murray.
Last week, in the National League Divisional Playoffs, the Chicago Cubs faced the Los Angeles Dodgers. In game one, the Cubs lost 7-2. In game two, they lost 10-3. And in game three, 3-1. What, as president, would you do to guarantee this never happens again? In your answer, please be specific.
That's a fair question, William, but let's face it. The Cubs may very well be in the playoffs again, perhaps even next year. If so, they will lose again. And they're going to keep right on losing year after year after year. Because that is what the Cubs do. We as a nation have got to wean Cubs fans away from supporting that team and retrain them to root for other teams. Teams that will actually have a chance of winning.
Senator McCain.
Here I have to agree with my opponent. Let me give you some straight talk, my friends. The Cubs will never win the pennant, much less the World Series. Junior over there, he won't tell you that. I just did.
All right, we've fallen a bit behind, so we're going to pick up the pace. Our next question is from Mark Ledoux, and it's for Senator McCain.
Senator McCain, while here in the U.S. our economy is suffering, in Iraq there's an economic boom. Shouldn't the government of that country reimburse us the cost of the war?
My friends.
Time. We'll go now to Susan Calkins, who has a question for Senator Obama. Ms. Calkins, quickly.
Senator Obama. Healthcare costs have exploded. As a full-time...
Mrs. Calkins, I'm sorry, your time is up.
Darn it!
We've almost no time left, and I'd like to get both our remaining questions in, so I'm going to ask David Kipp and Dalton Cheeks to read them simultaneously.
Senator Obama, as a teacher,
I have a military veteran. The Veterans Administration, it seems, would never speak for ourselves.
As president, how would you address this?
Senators, your simultaneous responses.
That's an excellent question.
Thank you for that question, Dalton.
Let me say,
to tell you sometime,
teachers are too important to the future of this country.
No veteran will go without the
help. Outrageous situation.
That's one promise I'll never break.
When I'm president,
as I'm a maverick,
that will change.
A reform-minded, straight-talking maverick.
It's unbelievable. We've got every question in with 9 seconds to spare. So clearly, this has been one of the finest presidential debates ever. I'd like to thank the candidates. Gentlemen, you're blocking my prompter there.